Don, I'd like you to meet Horace Cook.
We've met. Lincoln Center.
Of course.
Have a seat. Lane has brought it to my attention that Mr. Cook's son has approached us for work.
Actually, it was Don who thought it best, out of deference, to include you.
We're not psychiatrists. There is no confidentiality.
Well, that's not strictly true, but you are family, and, well, it appears to be a lot of money.
Bert seemed alarmed. What exactly happened in this meeting?
Well, you know, your son has a dream.
Yes, Hi-Li. When he first mentioned it, I assumed he was gambling, but he seems convinced of its financial potential.
And there's no reason to doubt that.
Are you drunk? It's like Polish handball. You can't even play it if you're left-handed. There's no wall on that side.
Well, then that's done with. We needn't be involved.
Bert, you know that's not the way the marketplace works. A man comes through your door, he knows what he wants, he's got the money to back it up. You do your best.
Perhaps I'm unclear, because I'm childless. But they're not.
Well, should you be lucky enough to strike gold, remember that your children weren't there when you were swinging the pick. I've seen his plan. It's gibberish. But if you refuse him, he'll only find someone else. My son lives in a cloud of success, but it's my success. Perhaps when that evaporates and his face is pressed against the reality of the sidewalk, he'll be of value to someone.
Kill or be killed, eat or be eaten. That's how I was raised.
So you want us to proceed?
When we put that money aside for him, he was a little boy. We didn't know what kind of person we were making.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Easy for you to say. He doesn't have your name.
You stay for lunch. No discussion.
Pleasure to see you again.
Pleasure.
I'll sign him tonight.